Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, with another in the series. Well, another experiment. I took an old reproducer that I was out in my junk parts box. And this is an old universal reproducer. It was originally built for lateral and vertical cuts, so you could rotate it on the tone arm. But over the years, it's made of pot metal. Over the years, it has just disintegrated. So whenever I come across these, I save them for the gaskets, the diaphragm, needle bar, screws, springs, etc., etc. But in this case, I just added a copper fitting so I could adapt it to the Victor phonograph and see how this one worked playing a vertical cut diamond disc. Now, I went through all my discs and I pull out all the ones that are damaged, and this one has gotten wet and it's all bubbled up on this side. This side, as you can see, is actually starting to delaminate, actually almost turning to powder. It's got a big raised rib in it, and you can just flick little pieces of it off. So, I use these for my experiments. The rest of the disc is actually in fairly good shape, but the lead-in groove, like I said, it's gotten wet, and it's really starting to come apart here. But it's good enough for an experiment. So, we'll see how this works. I've got it adapted on the Victor tone arm. It's not very pretty, but it is efficient. And it works. In this case, I just want to see how well it works and how it plays this disc. So, Edison Disc 50891R, it's you, Foxtrot. Rudy Wiedufs, Californians. So, let's see how this works, playing a diamond disc on a Victor phonograph. Thank you. as you can see, it actually works quite well. I don't know if you can tell in the video, this is really loud. It is louder than a Victor disc, I would say. You can hear it in every room in the house. In fact, you can hear it outside. It is quite loud, and it seems to work. It costs nothing. So if you're looking for a simple way to play diamond discs on something other than an Edison phonograph, this actually seems to work quite well. And you can adapt almost any reproducer to do this. It's just a matter of doing it. So far, I have not damaged a record doing this. I've only used the needle once for each play. But, of course, I'm using discs that are already damaged. But in the parts that I have played, there's no groove damage on these at all. And I have no doubt I could continue to play this probably 100 times. If it's not going to damage it the first play, it isn't going to damage it at all, period. So, just wanted to do a quick video on it. Really, really simple. Cost nothing. It was out of the junk box. And it works. It's efficient and it's loud. And it gives you a way to listen to diamond discs without an Edison phonograph. Using this configuration, in my opinion, these sound much better than they do on an Edison machine. And there's half the background noise, perhaps less than that. The first thing you hear when you start a disc on an Edison machine is constant throughout the entire disc. It's not that apparent on these. It actually sounds quite good. So just wanted to do a quick video so you could see it. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. Just continuing my experiments. Had the parts, thought I'd give it a try, see what it sounded like. And it works. Works quite well. So again, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.